Hello guys, welcome to preptab. This video is important for those of you who are appearing for JEE mains this year. In this video lecture, I'll be sharing an effective revision strategy that is needed to crack this exam, and along with that I'll share a tentative timetable that you can follow for these last 30 days. Clear? I'll also share what you can do to increase your score in the examination. Fine? So this is me, Himanshu. I'm a graduate from IIT Kharagpur. So let's begin. Okay, before starting, the first question that you should ask is, what is revision? Clear? So is revision of notes all that is required in a revision? Answer is no. It won't be sufficient to help you crack this exam. Second thing, and the most important thing that is required to crack this exam, is that you have to solve questions. You have to practice questions. Clear? So say for example, if you are revising gaseous state, clear, and you have allotted 4 hours to revise this chapter. So out of these 4 hours, you have to give 30 to 40 minutes max for revision of notes, and the remaining time, that is 3 hours 15 minutes approximately, should be given for question solving. Okay, now let us come to our first part of this video, that is how you can improve your marks. What is the strategy that you can follow to improve your marks? Clear? Before sharing these 4 steps, let me just share a data of JEE 2019. As you all might be aware, that the cutoff marks for 2019 JEE mains was 89, right? And total 240,000 students were selected for JEE Advanced. Clear? Now, let us just divide these 240,000 students. The student scoring 300 to 360 marks might be very few, right? Let us say 500 students scored between 300 to 360 marks, right? The remaining students, that is 239,500 students, scored between 89 to 300. Clear? Now, if you take out the average number of students on each mark between 89 to 300, the average number of students on each mark, on one single mark, if you will calculate, 1150. Now, one wrong question means you lose 5 marks. Now imagine the number of ranks you will be going down. So that is why it is very important that you have a strategy, or that you focus on what steps I need to follow to improve my marks. Clear? So now let us discuss what these 4 steps are. The first step that you have to focus on is thorough revision. What does revision comprise? I have already discussed notes, revising notes. In chemistry especially, you have to go through NCRT, read NCRT, and second, you have to revise all the formulas which are relevant for a particular chapter. Clear? After doing this, after completing your notes or whatever short notes you have made, then solve questions. You have to do that. This is the second but most important step of your revision. Fine? Now, there is a habit among students that while solving question, they solve one question and they check the answer immediately. Avoid this habit for these last 30 days. What you are going to do is solve 20 to 30 questions in a go, and after that check your answers. Clear? On doing this, you will be able to identify the number of correct and incorrect questions, which will help you in improving your efficiency, in decreasing these number of incorrect questions and increasing your number of correct questions. From these incorrect options, learn. Clear? Make sure that this mistake you're not going to commit again. And while revising, give your 100% to this revision, because this might be the last revision of this chapter. So make sure that you are covering it 100%. Don't leave anything on this topic. Clear? Second, test yourself regularly. It is very important that in these last 30 days, you are regularly giving mock test. Second thing that you have to do in this part is attempt as many questions as possible in that mock test. And third, you have to minimize your negative marks. These are the three things that you have to keep in mind while testing yourself. Clear? Now, third thing is very important, that is avoid distractions. For these last 30 days, please avoid socialization. Second point is that you have to avoid unnecessary thoughts. Clear? See, our mind is constantly at work and it is continuously making plans that I'll do this, I'll do this. No. For these 30 days, make a plan today that what you are going to do in these 30 days and follow that religiously. Don't let random thoughts hamper your 30-day plan. Clear? So avoid those thoughts and just give your heart and mind to your preparation. Clear? Now, our fourth step and most important step that is needed is daily target. See, you have to take a small step every day in these 30 days which will help you succeed in your exam. Clear? So what is needed is that you can divide the whole syllabus, physics, chemistry, maths on a daily basis. So you can make a daily strategy for physics that on day 1 you will complete this chapter, day 2 this chapter. I'll be sharing a daily strategy for chemistry in my video on success mantra for chemistry. Do watch that. And you can make the same strategy for physics as well as maths. Clear? So these are the four steps that will help you improve your marks in the examination. See, if I make a performance graph, that is, say I have rank on y-axis and days on x-axis. Clear? So this is day 1, day 2, and this is your D day. That is your day on which you have to give your exam. Both the students are at same level today, but on D day the performance of one student was this and the performance of second student was this. You know what made this difference? This difference was due to their own actions. Clear? So it is your actions which will help you wear the crown of success on that day. So be strict to yourself in these last 30 days. Clear? Okay. Now I'm going to share a 30-day strategy that you can follow. Clear? See, in these 30 days, what you are going to do is revision of your complete syllabus. Clear? Now you have three subjects, and as you can see, that in JEE mains, all the three subjects have equal weightage. Right? So that means all the three subjects require equal attention. Right? Now, since you have 30 days, it is expected that in these last 30 days, you devote at least 13 hours each day. Clear? So 13 hours have to be given daily to your preparation in these last 30 days. Fine? And one day you will keep as buffer, which is your last day before JEE mains. I'll tell you what you should do on this last day. Fine? Okay. First, now since you have to spend 13 hours of your day, so how are you going to take out that time? Let's discuss that. Out of these 13 hours, if you divide it equally into 3, you are devoting 4 hours 20 minutes to each subject. Clear? So 4 hours 20 minutes to physics, 4 hours 20 minutes to chemistry, and 4 hours 20 minutes to maths. You have to give it. Clear? And what about this last day? First thing that is of utmost importance is don't leave anything for this day. Clear? Now what you are supposed to do on this day? You have to revise all the formulas. When I'm saying all the formulas, matlab physics, chemistry, maths, all three subjects, all the formulas you have to revise on this day. And that will only be possible if you have done a thorough revision in these last 30 days. Fine. Now I have divided these 13 hours subject wise that you have to use for preparation each day. So I have divided a day into three slots. First is your morning slot, that is from 6 to 12. Then afternoon slot, that is 12 to 6. And then evening slot, that is again from 6 to 12. Clear? Now in each slot, you have to give 4 hours 20 minutes to each subject, to physics, to chemistry and to maths, right? Keep these 20 minutes for revision. And what is to be revised? Whatever you have studied in these 4 hours. Clear? Now I have divided these slots into settings. So first sitting you can give from 6 to 8 and then from 9 to 11:20. Clear? Third sitting from 1 to 5:20, that is a continuous sitting so that you don't have difficulty to give a long sitting of 3 hours in the examination. Clear? And fourth and fifth sitting for mathematics you can give from 6 to 8 p.m. and then from 9 to 11:20 again. Clear? So this is how you can divide your day into these slots and you can customize this plan as per your convenience. Clear? So this was an overall strategy that you may follow in these last 30 days. For specific strategy and timetable for chemistry, you can watch my video on success mantra for chemistry. And if you have any doubt or query, you can mail them at preptabmail@gmail.com. Or you can just post them in the comment section below. So if you like the video, please do like, share and subscribe. Thank you for watching.